Hello, welcome to this video, dedicated to the newest Adobe Audition CC. Let's get a general overview on all you need to know to start using it. Please consider to visit our YouTube channel and our official website to get extra tips and content on Adobe and other companies' products. Adobe Audition is a professional and easy-to-use digital audio workstation product, suitable for both beginner and professional audio engineers. Offering simple and complete solutions to enhance and adjust your music samples up to your final audio playlist. Being part of the Creative Cloud Suite, you can get this product just under a subscription plan. Audition CC opens on its main workspace with the editor panel on the center, used to preview and edit your product in progress, and several panels around collecting samples, effects, and properties. In case any of these is missing, you can reopen it by going to the Window tab on top. Audition offers two main versions of this workspace from the top left corner. Use Waveform to check and edit single audio samples independently, and Multitrack to combine your audio files together, realizing the final output sound. Let's start with the Waveform workspace. To import audio files, just drag and drop these inside the editor panel. Audition supports several audio file formats, from the uncompressed .wav to the most common .mp3, but also videos with sound. It does not support MIDI files at all. All these files are listed under the Files tab on the left. Here, double-click on any file to open it on the editor, showing each of its stereo channels with their sound waveforms in green color, and also their frequency spectrum at the bottom, with intensity represented with colors from violet to yellow per each sound frequency from bottom to top, represented as notes and octaves on the right. You can zoom in and out on the editor by using your mouse wheel. On top, the navigator represents the section the editor shows and can be moved and extended in time as you like. At the bottom, use the player to play back and pause the current sample. The time placement is indicated by a red marker that can be moved by clicking and dragging on the timeline above. By default, the timeline measures time in minutes and seconds, but you can change it in bars and beats by right-clicking on it and going to Time Display. To playback part of the sample in loop, just click and drag on its waveform to select any portion in white color and then enable Loop Playback at the bottom. Whereas use Skip Section to skip the selected part instead. In addition, you can enable the record button to record with your microphone on the sample itself, starting from where the red marker is. Consider that this overrides any preset on the sample. You can use the L and R buttons on the right to mute and unmute either the left or the right stereo channels. At the bottom, the Levels panel shows the volume level in decibels for both the stereo channels. In case you get any red level and wrist distortion, you can use the volume HUD to reduce and balance the volume on either whole sample or any selected part if present. Use Ctrl and X, C, and V to cut, copy, and paste any selected region. If you make any mistake, you can always undo it by using Ctrl and Z or the History window on the left. Audition collects several audio effects you can apply to your sample from the Effects Rack window. At first, its list is empty, having no effects applied. To add any effect, just click on the right arrow and browse for the interested effect, adjusting its properties and options. This effect appears on the list with its name and an I/O button you can use to disable and enable it. You can also right-click on it to edit its properties and remove the effect from the list. On mix, you can shuffle between wet and dry to increase or decrease the volume of the affected sound rather than the original one. The effects added on the sample are not applied definitely. To render the effects on the sample, use the Apply button. With Process, you can choose whether to apply the effects on the whole sample or just any selected part on the editor. When your audio samples are ready, you can use the Multitrack workspace to put these together and realize your final project called Session. When you switch to Multitrack, you are asked to create a new session by defining name, location, sample rate, and bit depth. This session opens on the editor with audio tracks per row and also listed under the Files panel. At this point, just import the samples you need by dragging and dropping these on any audio track in time. When adding videos, a dedicated video reference track is made to welcome video frames that can't be modified inside Audition. At the bottom, you find the master track, which does not collect any sample, but the whole output sound coming from the audio tracks above it. All the added samples are shown as blocks called clips, with the same color of the audio tracks that collect these. You can enlarge tracks by using your mouse wheel and holding down the Alt key and zoom in and out with the Control key. Now let's see how to edit clips with the Time Selection tool enabled. Click on any clip to select it. Drag it from its top edge to move it in time on the same track or in another one. You can also drag from the lateral edges to stretch in time by cutting part of the waveform. Whereas if you drag from the white corners, you can stretch and shorten the clip by changing its speed rate below or above the original 100%. In addition, you can also pull the yellow and the blue envelope lines on the clip to adjust its volume and its stereo panning, respectively. You can also drag from the squares on top to add fade transitions and begin or end the clip by changing its volume gradually in time. This is automatically created in case you overlap clips with the same track. On the left, use the Properties panel to adjust other clip properties, such as pitch or muting. To cut, copy, and paste, you can select any part and use Ctrl and X, C, and V as seen on the waveform interface. To split clips into multiple pieces, enable the Razor tool instead. On the left side, you have several options to manage the content of each single track. You can use the M, Mute, and the S, Solo buttons to mute the current track, or all the others except the current one. Use the R button to arm the current track and record on it when enabling the Record button below. Adjust the whole track volume and balance the left and the right channels with the knobs. To adjust effects, you can use the Effects rack, choosing Clip Effects to apply effects on the selected clip and Track Effects to apply these on the track selected. Inside the Multitrack workspace, you can open the Mixer panel to manage the output from all the tracks, adjusting volume, sources, and options. To save your work in progress, go to File and then to Save As. This saves the current sample file on the waveform interface or the whole session as a .sesx file if you use the Multitrack workspace. Whereas to render and export your project, go to File, Export, Multitrack Mixdown, and set Name, Location, File Format, and Sample Rate. On Mixdown options, choose whether to export the master track, so the whole session sound, or any single track. Thanks for watching this video. Make sure to visit our YouTube channel to discover more about Adobe Creative Cloud products.